Hi, this is Dr. Graves back with part two of the landslides video tutorial. When we left off, we had just created the Browns Canyon watershed layer, and at this point we're going to join the data from the streams layer to the Browns Canyon watershed layer. Here's how you do that. Right click on Browns Canyon watersheds and select joins and relates. Select join, and rather than joining attributes from a table, this time we're going to join data from another layer based on spatial locations. Select that. We're going to join streams layer data to our Browns Canyon watershed data, and we want to select thumb. And then in step three, perhaps go here and change the name of the output file to something like streams join, because we're joining the streams data to our watershed. Click OK and let the tool run. Yet another file appears, this time called streams join. Notice it is in this table of contents. You can click clear selected features now if you would like. If you open the streams join attribute table by right clicking and selecting attribute table, you will notice that there are additional columns. In addition to area and mean slope, you now have the maximum stream elevation and the minimum stream elevation plus the total length, or the sum of the streams in each of the watershed. And we're going to use these values to create two new columns of data that we can use to put in our regression formula later. How do we do that? Right click on the down arrow associated with table options and select add field. And name the field RR for relief ratio and make it a floating variable. Relief ratio is essentially the steepness or the rise over run of the streams in each data. Click OK. Repeat the process. Select table options, down arrow, add a second field, and the second field is going to be called area in kilometers, and make that a floating variable as well. If you scroll to the far right of your attribute table, you will notice that RR and area KM have null values in each instance, and in order to fill these values, you have to use something called the field calculator. Activate the field calculator by right-clicking on the column header RR, select field calculator, select yes. You may be able to copy and paste this formula from your instruction sheet and paste it in here if you would like. The other way to do it is to type it in manually, left parentheses, sum max, subtract sum minimum elevation, left parentheses, division sign, you can click here as well, and then double click on sum shape length. Remember to double click to select the variables. Either way, click OK and let the calculator do its job. Now repeat the process with area in kilometers, select field calculator, select yes. You'll have to erase the old formula, highlight and press delete. And for this formula, we are just going to double click on area to select it, and we're going to divide it by 1 million in order to get area in kilometers from area in, well, meters or square meters. 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I believe that's enough. Click OK. And you're finished with this part. Answer a question or two in Moodle, and this concludes part 2 of this video tutorial.